الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأصلي وأسلم على رسول الله صلاة وتسليما يليقان بالحبيب المصطفى النبي المجتبى صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وتابعيه وتابعي تابعيه إلى يوم الدين. أحبتي وأحبائي في الله، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. First, يعني أرجوك جزاك الله خيرا. يعني you saw me having سنة العشاء, so I lost my balance. And he waited till I'm done and rushed to me and say, "How are you? Are you okay?" I said, "Joko, Alhamdulillah, I'm okay. It's just a matter of age." But Jazakallah khairan for caring. Yani, you're among few people who do care about their imam. And Jazakallah khairan. Though some other people don't care, I can take it. I can take it. No problem. No problem. No problem. Alhamdulillah. It's hot. I got a signal saying it's hot. I don't know. The AC, good luck. AC. Maybe it is the atmosphere is making it hot, so we can stand it, inshallah. Some people in the community are saying that in Masjid al-Iman, the imam is teaching lessons in love. I can't deny it, I do. Why not we teach lessons in love? As long as it is coming from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to his companions, subhanallah rabbil alameen, asking them what you love the most, going to Abu Bakr, to Umar, to Uthman, to Ali, to Abu Dharr, and asking them what you love the most. And each and every single one of them has given us what he loved the most. We may learn from them to find out or identify something in this dunya we love the most. And as an exercise I have given to you the other night, saying that pick up something in this dunya, one or two or three things you love the most, keep it to yourself till we're done with those lessons of love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as well as the Sahaba, to compare what you have to what they have. The first lesson of love on Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ask Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu wa ardah. Abu Bakr said three things I love the most: al-julusu bayna yadayka wa nadhara ilayka wa infaqul mali alayka. Ya Rasulullah, I love to sit with you. Ya Rasulullah, I love to look at you. Ya Rasulullah, I love to spend my money in whatever you tell me to spend on. Umar, the same question, Umar, what you love the most? He told Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَمْرٌ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَلَوْ كَانَ سِرًّا وَنَهْيٌ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَلَوْ كَانَ جَهْرًا وَقَوْلُ الْحَقِّ وَلَوْ كَانَ مُرًّا. Umar, to joining for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, calling people to come to the righteousness, even if it is done in a secret way, or abstain or be away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us to be away from, even if I have to do it in public. And then tell the truth no matter what, even if it is very bitter against you, you say it. This is what Umar loved to do. Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu arda told us that he loved three things: it'aamu at'aam, وإفشاء السلام، والصلاة بالليل، والناس نيام. عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه وأرضاه loved to feed people, loved to say السلام عليكم to people around him, love to pray at night while people are sleeping. قيام الليل or تهجد. علي رضي الله عنه وأرضاه telling رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم what he loved the most. إكرام الضيف والصوم بالصيف وضرب العدو بالسيف. To honor and welcome his guests the best way ever. And fasting during summertime, long, hot, humid days. And then being one of the best fighters for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, utilizing his sword against the enemies of Islam and Muslims. And then it came to Abu Dharr al-Ghafari, radiallahu anhu arda, telling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the three things he loved the most in this dunya, al-ju' wal-marad wal-maut. Abu Dharr loves to be hungry, loves to be sick, loves to die. But he gave us the explanation of why he has chosen those three things. أُحِبُّ الْجُوعَ لِيَرِقَّ قَلْبِي. I love to be hungry for my heart to be softened, to feel for those who are hungry and need to be fed. وَأَحُبُّ الْمَرَضَ لِيَخِفَّ ذَنْبِي. And I love to be sick for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to erase all of my bad deeds, all of my sins. So the sickness would help me get rid of all of those bad deeds and sins in my record. وَأَحُبُّ الْمَوْتَ لِأَلْقَى رَبِّي. I love to die in order to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no need for me to stay longer in this dunya. What I am doing in this dunya, I love to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the only way to meet him just to die. It came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam telling the sahaba and telling us what he loved the most, and he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at-tibu wal-nisa'u wa ju'ilat qurrata 'ayni fi as-salah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loves perfume, loves to wear wonderful perfume to smell good, to show that yani, I'm here with that wonderful smell, not very bad or negative smell, subhanallah rabbil alamin. When he said women, not in a sexual sense like the Orientalists and the enemies of Islam are saying, look at him, how many wives he get married to and so on and so forth. He was really concerned about women, our mothers, our wives, our sisters, our daughters, how they must be treated in a fair way, in a just way. As he knew, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even in his last speech, khutbat al-wada', usikum bin-nisa'i khayra, I advise you to be the best ever for you women, whoever those women are. Mothers, wives, daughters, sisters, he knew that sometimes, subhanallah, they would be mistreated unfairly and unjustly. Take for instance this country, how many years back women even had the rights to vote. Just a few years back, have the rights to vote. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has predicted that we have to treat them the best way ever. And then Jibreel alayhi salam wanted to share Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba radwanullah alayhim ajma'in and us as well. Jibreel alayhi salam nazala wa aqra'ahum as-salam, greeting all of them, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba with the greeting of Islam, assalamu alaykum, wa qala wa ana uhibbu min dunyakum thalath. I love three things in your dunya, in here Jibreel: tablighu ar-risala wa ada'u al-amana wa hubb al-masakin. Allahu Akbar. That revelation came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Quran. Two, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I brought it down in 23 years. Quran is completed. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-islam deena. Quran has completed. All of it came to you. You do have it. You memorize it. You understand it. You comprehend it. You act upon it. Now it is your job to teach it to people around you. تبليغ الرسالة, the first thing. وأداء الأمانة, if you are entrusted with something, you have to fulfill it. Whatever that trust is, especially when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has entrusted us with this deen, the deen, this is a trust. Allah has entrusted us with it. So we have to convey it, we have to preach it, we have to reach out for people to learn our deen. وَحُبُّ الْمَسَاكِينَ Love poor people. That's what Jibreel said. Love poor people. Poor people are in need. Living in poverty, homeless, you name it, they need our care. Don't tell me, here in this country, they can go to a life or food stamps or human service or Section 8 housing and all of this kind of thing. And I don't care about them. Uncle Sam can take care of them. Yes, we're paying tax money for this. Yes, part of it would go to this. But it is an obligation upon me to find out myself who are those poor people, miskeen, and go and take care of them. Provide them with whatever you can. This is Jibreel alayhi salam. And I left you last night with another surprise, and I wanted to share it with you tonight, inshallah. Who's next to say, here is what I love the most for you? ثم صعد جبريل إلى السماء وتنزل مرة أخرى وقال جبريل told them what he loved the most. He went up to the heavens and then came back. وقال الله عز وجل يقرئكم السلام ويقول الله سبحانه وتعالى does convey the salam to you saying السلام عليكم to all of you. ويقول إنه يحب من دنياكم ثلاث. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that He loves three things in your dunya, Muslim. You Muhammad, you Sahaba, and so on and so forth. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the most? Ready? Are we ready to know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the most in this dunya? I don't think we're ready. Some people are talking or busy with some other things. Maybe they do not want to know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves for us. Ready? Do you know what Allah loves for us? Are we? لِسَانًا ذَاكِرًا وَقَلْبًا خَاشِعًا وَجَسَدًا عَلَى الْبَلَاءِ صَابِرًا. Allahu Akbar. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves from this dunya for us to do. The choice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِسَانًا ذَاكِرًا A tongue always remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you might be wondering, yani why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the tongue to be one of the most beloved one or one of the most things he would love for us? Why the tongue? Yani that tongue could say wonderful, great, sweet things and can say totally the opposite. So that's why we have to watch it. What you say. Think and rethink about what you're going to utter, what you're going to say to yourself, to your spouse, to your children, to anyone around you before you say it. Control your tongue. أمسك عليك لسانك. That's what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Hold your tongue. Watch your tongue. Observe what your tongue is going to say. And even the Sahaba, Ridwanullah alayhim ajma'een, yani, companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, were wondering and asking Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, awa nahnu mu'akhaduna bima natafawuhu bihi, Ya Rasulullah. O the Messenger of Allah, are we held accountable before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in what we are saying? In what we are saying, they were wondering, when he told them, hold your tongue, watch your tongue, observe your tongue. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, telling them that, وَهَلْ يَكُبُّ النَّاسُ عَلَىٰ وُجُوهِهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ إِلَّا حَصَائِدُ أَلْسِنَتِهِمْ. In the day of judgment, what would really severely drag their people in their faces, in their nose, on the ground, what their tongue have said in this dunya. And each and every one in the whole universe, in the day of judgment, when you see someone has been dragged severely on the ground, there they would know that's because of his tongue. What he said. Everyone would know. I have to be careful. I have to be extra careful in what we're saying. Either in front of someone or behind the back of that one. In terms of ghibah, backbiting, stabbing, mentioning something never happened to that person. Sit down with someone and say, hey, you know what he said, you know what he did, hey, you know this, have you seen that night when we were there and that day and so on and so on? Oh yeah, I have seen it, yeah, I have seen also, let me share with you what he said about that situation, without any justification, subhanAllah, the tongue. And we keep going on and on and on and on, backbiting, stabbing that person behind himself till that person would become worse than a shaitan. And of course, from that person to that person, it's only two. And then from two to a third one, to a fourth one, to fifth one. So it's all over in the community. So that person become, wal'ayadu billah, worse than the shaitan. Because one word was said. One word was said. One word was said about that person. Without any justification, without any justice, without finding out exactly what happened. Go and ask. Don't keep it to yourself. Don't keep talking about it. Never. This is what would kill and destroy any community. The backbiting. And slandering, namima. You go from someone to someone, here is what he said, here is what he did, here is what he act, here is what, Ya Allah, what you're trying to do in here? What you're trying? That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved from us was lisanan dhakira. That tongue always remember him, be away of all of those bad things, all of those negative things. Say, Ya Allah, Ya Rabb, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Shaitan comes to you, say, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim. That tongue. That's why in the Quran you say, Idhkurullaha yadhkurkum. Remember Allah. Allah will do what? Will remember us. Remember us with His mercy. Remember us with His forgiveness. Remember us in front of all of the malaika. Say, that person remember me, I remember him. But that person forget me, I forget him. نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ. He forgets me, I forget him. That's it. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in here, Jibreel coming to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Sahaba, Allah loves the most, لِسَانًا ذَاكِرًا. Even if it is not for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remember him, for your own sake. How? I don't feel good about things. I have a lot of discomfort in my life. I'm not relaxed at all. I have a lot of bad things. Agony, sadness, grief, depressed, you name it. How you treat all of those things? أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبَ. Remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, certainly, definitely, without any doubt. Just saying, Ya Allah, Wallahi, or La ilaha illallah, or Ya Rabb, or Subhanallah, or Alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Any of these, just mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it would comfort your heart. It would bring tranquility, relaxation. You try it. Yani in any situation. Any situation you're in and you feel bad about something, not feeling good about something, being depressed about something, you know, just sit to yourself all of a sudden, Ya Rabb, or Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah. See how you feel. See how you feel. Don't take any medication for that depression or anxiety or being worried about something. Just say, أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبَ. Very easy medication. You don't have to have an appointment with a doctor. You don't have to have a medical coverage or medical insurance. You don't have to do anything about it. Just that tongue Allah has given to you as a gift, utilize it in the way Allah loves. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Allahu Akbar. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves that لِسَانًا ذَاكِرًا. We got it? We got it? I want to hear yes or no. If you did not get it, let me repeat it more and more. Let me explain more and more how important, severely important in our life that tongue. That tongue. That tongue. وَقَلْبًا خَاشِعًا. Allah loves that qalb with khushu'. What khushu' means in here? How you humble yourself. Get yourself down to earth. Always work in your heart there in order for this heart to be thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, recently, and I'm not a heart expert or a heart surgeon, or, but I know my limited expertise in counseling, in psychology. Most of the heart diseases nowadays, most of it, and I'm not saying all of it, most of it, wallahi, it is mainly because that heart is not firmly connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not. You know why? We